The landing gear is one of the most important parts of an airplane. Without it, the plane can't taxi or take off, and landing can be extremely dangerous if it isn't properly deployed. Not only that, it must support the weight of the aircraft, which can reach over 500 tons and which moves at 200 km per hour during takeoff and landing. Although the landing gear may look simple, it's much more complex than you might think. It's made up of many components, each playing an important role. In addition, there are several landing gear arrangements, tail dragger, tricycle, tandem and quadricycle, as well as several types of landing gear, fixed and retractable. In this video, I'll explain how the landing gear of an airplane works. Landing gear normally comes in two arrangements. The first one is a tail dragger, where two main wheels are placed somewhere in the front, and one smaller one at the rear. And the second arrangement is a tricycle, where two main wheels are placed under the wings and one under the nose. Both arrangements are used today, although the tail dragger was more common during the early propeller era, as it allowed more room for clearance. Modern aircraft, particularly commercial ones, tend to use the tricycle arrangement. Also, the tail dragger has one disadvantage, which is the fact that it's quite unstable. That's why it requires additional pilot training. Some tricycle airplanes are equipped with tail strike protection, which is usually either a small wheel or skids or bumpers. It protects the underside of the fuselage if over-rotation occurs on takeoff, leading to a tail strike. Airplanes such as the Concorde, Boeing 727 and B-29 are equipped with tail strike protection. There are other arrangements as well, like a bicycle, which is what the U-2 plane uses, and quadricycle arrangement, which B-52 uses, but they are not as common. Landing gear adds a significant amount of drag and noticeably slows the plane. To avoid it, some planes feature retractable landing gear. Most retractable gear is hydraulically operated, though some are electrically operated or even manually operated on a very light aircraft. It's very important that the landing gear is reliable and deployed when necessary, as landing without it can be extremely dangerous, although still possible. Pilots can ensure that the landing gear is down by looking at the three indicator lights, each referring to one of the three wheels. Because of how important landing gear is, there are several redundant systems that allow the airplane to land safely, even in the event of a failure. Some airplanes, such as the Boeing 747, have four separate and independent hydraulic systems and four main landing gear struts. A safe landing will be possible if two landing gear struts fail, provided they are on the opposite sides of the fuselage. In the event of a power failure, the landing gear can be released manually with a pump, or with a mechanical freefall mechanism that disengages the lifting mechanisms and allows the landing gear to fall by gravity. Airplanes land with tremendous force. Given that some planes can weigh up to 500 tons, it's important to absorb some of the energy to prevent damage to the aircraft. For this reason, most airplanes are equipped with shock absorbers. Shock absorbers generally come in two types, solid and hollow struts. Solid shock absorbers are, as the name suggests, solid. They consist of metal rods that flex under impact. Such shock absorbers are the simplest and are usually only used in small aircraft. Hollow struts are more advanced. They use pressurized air or oil to absorb shocks. Most hollow struts have a cylinder. Inside the cylinder is air or oil. When landing on a runway, the force of the landing moves a piston into the cylinder, thus pressurizing the contained air or oil. Considering that some planes can weigh over 500 tons, three wheels are not enough to support such weight. The Airbus A320, which weighs less than 100 tons, has six wheels, two at the front and four under the wings. The largest civilian airplane, the Boeing A380, has 22 wheels, two in front and 20 under the wings. And the largest airplane in the world, the N225, has four wheels in the front and 28 in the back, 32 in total. As you can see, the landing gear is much more complex than it may initially appear. It's a crucial part of the airplane, responsible for 5% of its weight and 1.5% of its cost. Considering that the price of a new Airbus A380 is $500 million, the landing gear alone is worth several million. So the next time you see an airplane land or take off, hopefully you'll appreciate landing gear engineering a little more. Thank you for watching. See you soon.